So I'm gonna replace Lufio. And this is a talk I gave 2 years ago in Barcelona. It's totally unprepared. I removed the part with the demonstration and stuff like that because I don't have anything set to prepare that. So anyway, we will start about a small introduction to Proteus. So we will see what is Proteus, what are the use cases of Proteus, some of the features, some drawbacks, and then summary, which is basically you should use Proteus. So what is Proteus? Proteus is a Python library. So just like any good Python library, it's pip installable, so you can do a pip install Proteus into your shell, and it will fetch Proteus and install it into your environment or anything. You can use it in your script, but if you want, you can also use Proteus inside your Python shell and connect to a Triton object and interact with them. The code in Proteus is quite small, but it has some advanced Python features. So it's a good starting point to get used to with those advanced features. There are the descriptors, which is a way to define some more properties. Metaclasses, which I don't know if you know about metaclasses, but it's classes of class, where hence the meta in metaclasses. And there is also context managers, which is where you use with something, then do other stuff. It defines methods to be called before entering a context and then after entering a context. You can use Proteus to connect to a local Triton server this way. So you just use from Proteus import config, then you define the config file and then you go. This command will import a local Triton D module initialized with the configuration in the config file using the credential you put there. But you can also access a remote Triton server using XML RPC, and you just have to put the URL of the Triton server. So of course you have to have the Triton server listening on the port 8069 in this case, and the syntax to specify the credential is the usual syntax in the URL that you can use also in browsers and stuff. So I said that Proteus is a Triton library to access Triton as a client. So Proteus is built to mimic the Triton client because, as Cedric said just a few minutes ago, Proteus was built initially to test Triton. So it will act just like when you are in the client and clicking on buttons and so on. So the default values are set when you create a new object. The unchanged and unchanged with calls are triggered when you set a property. For example, you say sale.party equals, I don't know, and it will automatically make the unchange on the party, call the server, receive the value for the new fields, and put the value in the fields. And the context on the fields is used, then the Python expression in the context are evaluated. So you can test your context that you have written into your module. So Proteus is used for automated testing. We add at that time 29 dog test files. No, it must be a bit more test files, probably 8 or 7 more. It mimics the client, and it's used to make the scenarios, to make the functional testings. And we are also testing access rights, the workflows, the wizards, the errors. And since 2010, we have added also testing the report, which was quite important because I remember a bug we had a few days ago because it was missing a test on the report. And it was my fault. So Proteus can also be used to automate tasks. For example, if you go to demo.triton.org, you will see that there is already data entered into the system. And this is by using Proteus. You can also use the Proteus to import data from legacy databases. That's usually the way we do. So you can receive a CSV file, DBF file, PostgreSQL, maybe. Yeah, no, you can. And we, at B2CK, we use it also to generate timesheet reports to send to our customers weekly or monthly, I don't remember. We don't use it anymore? Ah, okay, we don't use it anymore. Proteus can also be used while you are developing. I must say that I don't do it anymore, but yeah, you still can do it. So it's easy when you want to repeat a process of actions that create a bug. And with Proteus, you just create your small script of what to do instead of going to the client, clicking everywhere, and it's boring, and so on. You just enter the same data, you execute the same wizard, you click on the same buttons, and just from your shell or your prompt, and yeah, you're happy, because you're gaining time. No, I tend to write more tests, but... So the supported fields types, every Triton type is supported by Proteus, all of them. I believe it's still true. Proteus can also call buttons, just like I said. For example, we have here a say, we set a party on the say, we set a sale date. We create a new line in the sale, we set a product on the sale line, a quantity that is random, we save the sale. And then we can call the button there. The syntax, in fact, there is not the right one anymore. No, you can make a sale.click and call quote directly. It has changed. And so the next one. We can also execute wizards. This hasn't changed. Yes, this hasn't changed, so that's simple, you just create your wizard there, then you execute one transition. In fact, when you are creating a wizard, you have named transitions, and you execute them. In case you have a form popping up, you can access this by accessing the form property of the wizard. So here, company config has the form property. We set it to a temporary name variable here. And we create the party, we set the party to the form, we set the currency, then we execute the app transition on the wizard, and the data we have put there will be sent to the Triton process and execute, and the transition will be executed in the wizard. Where Proteus could be better? If you want to import a lot of records, Proteus is not meant to be fast, because it's a tool for testing and small importation. If you need to import 2 gigabytes of parties, maybe you should use something else. The API could be better for buttons, but it's already the case. And Proteus does not speak JIS on your PC. Well, that's not a big problem. But Proteus is still cool. You can use it to learn cool Python features because it's not big and it's full of those features. You can write tests and script with it, and it's important to test stuff. You have auto-completion in your IPython shell, for example. So please pip install Proteus and test your development.